get to what I wanted to talk about. All right. I need a drink now for this one. Okay. In the comments, I want everybody to comment, obviously, what kind of fitness watch you either have or wish you had. Go ahead and pop them in the comments. This is a Garmin something. I think it's a VivoFit. I don't know. But it's Christmas time. These are a very common Christmas gift. Put in the comments what kind you have. I'm going somewhere with this. Besides free advertising for companies who don't sponsor us. We're not big and cool and important enough for people to sponsor us. That would be awesome, though. But we're not there yet. But yeah, mine is a VivoFit. I lost the little, you know, the little thing that holds this down? I lost it. So now it drives me nuts. But I've got this happening. So, yeah. Everybody comment what you have. Do you have an Apple Watch, a Samsung Watch, a Garmin, a Fitbit? That's the most common one, I think. Pop it in the comments. Reason I'm asking. I have grown a lot in the... How many years have I been doing this now? Seven years that I've been doing this. When I first began Faithful Fitness and first began my fitness journey, I was obsessed with the number on the scale. And I think a lot of people are there. And I don't even know if it was so much the number on the scale I was hooked on as much as it was the number on the tags. The number on the tags on my clothes. What department I got to shop in. What stores I couldn't shop in because they didn't carry my size. I started out, I was very, very hooked on the numbers. I was addicted to the number on the scale and the number on the tags. And as I gave my fitness journey to God and gave my health, my weight, my scale, all of that to God, I started to see a lot of progress and I started to see a lot of change in my body. My body was changing. It was getting smaller. It was getting stronger. I started to be happier with the numbers that I was seeing on my tags and on the scale. And I started not dreading them as much, and they started to not have control over me like they used to. But something that I think can happen is we can jump out of one ditch to fall into another. And I actually, if you go back on our YouTube page, under the speaking events, the very, very first time I ever spoke, it was at the King's Daughters Conference. And the verse that I focused on for that talk for King's Daughters several years ago was 1 Corinthians 6:12, and I have it down here. You say I'm allowed to do anything, but not everything is good for you. And even though I am allowed to do anything, I must not become a slave to anything. Even by that point, I was no longer a slave to the scale. It was awesome. I was no longer a slave to my tag because it didn't bother me anymore because I was at a place where I was happy with it. But I was still a slave to a number. I jumped out of the ditch of being controlled by the number on the weight on the scale. And instead, I began to be controlled by the number on this thing. And I've gone through several fitness watches over the years. I actually started out with the Polar FT4, the one that is the band that goes around you. That's the one I started with. That's before these became really, really popular. And I would strap it on before every class. That was back when I was teaching in Linton. at the Christian church there in Linton, long time ago. And I started to be almost addicted to seeing how many calories I could burn, because I hit my goal weight. So that number didn't control me anymore. And I was wearing the size clothes I'd always wanted to. So that number didn't control me anymore. So it became a matter of being controlled by what this was telling me. Whether or not my workout was a success, whether or not I felt like I accomplished anything, whether or not I felt like it mattered, whether or not I felt just success in general, depended on what this told me. If I did a really hard workout and I was dripping sweat and I checked my watch and I've been working out for an hour and it said I only burned like 300 calories, I could actually feel my stomach drop, because I'm like, I did all that work for 300 calories, seriously? Flip side, if I did a really intense turbo kick class, because that one used to kick my butt, and I burned, you know, 600 some odd calories, I felt like I'd really done something. Like, oh, okay, the watch validated me. The watch told me I did a good job. So that would put me in a good mood. You know, whenever you think about what controls you, you have to ask, what does it mean for it to control you? What determines your mood for the day? If you weigh yourself first thing in the morning and you allow it to set the tone for your entire day, then that scale is controlling you. Said that for years. But if you can't do a workout without seeing how many calories you burned at the end, and how many calories you burned at the end, that determines whether or not that was a good workout. Well, now this is controlling you. And these can be great. And, you know, I had somebody say something to me once about, you know, having my Garmin on and being able to start it. You know, I used to start every single class saying, you know, tell your wrist you're working out. And somebody said something about, you know, not mattering or something like that. I'm like, oh, well, it's just a fun little game to play with yourself, you know, kind of beat your personal best, things like that. But deep down, I think it was a lot more than that. Deep down, it was, if I don't burn at least 400 calories in an hour, I didn't do good enough. I'm not enough if this doesn't tell me I'm enough. I can go to one of Ashley's classes, which everyone who's been to Ashley's class, can I get an amen? And I can have my back end handed to me by Ashley, which has happened many times over the years. But if this didn't tell me I burned at least 400 or 500 calories, it didn't matter how many times she motivated me and encouraged me and told me how great of a job I was doing. It didn't matter. Because if this thing didn't tell me, I didn't believe it. And I don't think I even realized how much I was focused on that number until I went to Arizona for retreat. Because, see, I pride myself in being able to be the lightest packer on the planet. I'm known within our platoon for being a light packer. 1 week retreat, carry on in a backpack. So when I went to retreat, I didn't pack my charger for my watch because it was just one more thing to remember, one more thing to pack. So I charged it up really good before I left. And then I'm like, okay, I'll have a watch as long as it's alive. Well, when you start and stop it to tell it you're working out, it sucks the battery down faster. And I was working out 3 or 4 hours a day on the mountain. So I never told it I was working out because I'm like, you know what? I'm going to the mountain for a whole lot more than just a workout. I want to get my battery to last so I have my watch as long as possible. I'm not going to turn it on the entire week that I'm gone just to save battery. And that whole week, I slowly, without even realizing it, stopped caring how many calories I burned. And I was working out a lot. See, Karina was on here. I don't know if she, yeah. I don't know if Karina's, I have two Karinas. What are the odds? But Karina was one of my cabin mates, so she can attest. Ashley can definitely attest because she had a bottom cabin, so I don't even want to hear it from her because I had to do steps. But we worked out hard, and I found myself not caring how many calories I burned. Didn't matter. Look what my body did. I don't care what the watch said. It can just tell me the time. Well, I got home from retreat. And without even realizing it, I hadn't recorded a workout to find the calories. I mean, I hadn't done it since I got back, and we've been home, what, a month now? And I've not actually turned this thing on to tell it I'm working out in a month. So I decided to see, today's Thursday. Yesterday, for my Ruth House class, that's my combination class. So it's arguably one of the hardest classes that I, harder classes that I teach because there's a big variety that I accomplish. 51 minutes, 300, Eli took my phone. I don't know, 300 and something calories. And I saw that and I didn't care. I think it was the first time I didn't care. So you might notice that I'm not going to tell you at the beginning of class to tell your wrist you're working out anymore. Because telling my wrist that I'm working out became an idol to me. And I didn't even realize it. Because I wasn't looking for my sufficiency. I wasn't looking for who I am. I wasn't looking for my validation from God. I was looking at it from this thing. I don't need this thing because you know what? Whether it tells me I am or not. And even more so, my body's gonna move the way God wants it to move. Not because I'm trying to beat my high score like I'm some living version of a Pac-Man game, but because I get to move, because I get to work out, because I get to, because it's a joy, because I offer my body as a living sacrifice, holy and pleasing to God, and this is true and proper worship. That's why I work out, not to beat my personal best. I don't work out so that I can earn or punish myself for something that I ate. I work out because my body's a temple of the Holy Spirit. And if I've got God living inside of me, I'm going to take care of the place. So I don't know where you are on your journey. I hope that you've balanced somewhere in the middle. But if you're at a place where you're still controlled by the number on the scale or the number on your tag, or and those numbers dictate your mood for the day and dictate and tell you how to feel about yourself, I'm praying for you because I've been there and you're not alone. But the important thing is you don't have to stay there. But on the other hand, when you get out of there, whenever you get out of that ditch, if you overcorrect and land in the other one where your success and how good of a day you had depends on numbers again, but this time it's, did I eat the right number of calories? Are my macros balanced perfectly? How many carbs did I have today? How many grams of protein did I gain? How many calories did I burn? How many steps did I get in? Those are all numbers. It's all data. But data doesn't tell me who you are. And data doesn't tell you who God says you are. So if you've jumped out of one ditch to land in the other ditch, I'm praying for you too, because I didn't even know that ditch was there until I got out of it. So I'm not going to tell you to tell your wrist you're working out anymore, because Your wrist isn't what tells you who you are. Your wrist isn't what tells you how much effort you put into something. I don't want to give this thing that much power anymore. I'm still going to wear it because I think it's real handy that my wrist buzzes when my phone rings and my kids hid my phone somewhere in the house. Thank you, dear. Joe has it. It's handy. I like being able to read my text messages on it. But I don't care how many steps I got in today. I did my Advent time. I did some praying. I did some teaching. Taught a class. Spent some time with my kids. Snuggled on him. None of that's measured in steps on a watch. I don't care how many calories I burned at drumming tonight. I had fun. There were four of us, which I'm going to call a win for December. Had some Christmas music. It was a good time. I was sweating at the end. I was holding a plank and literally like drippage. Like there's a lot of my DNA on the floor upstairs at church right now. I don't need to know how many calories I burn. Doesn't matter. Save my watch battery anyway. If you are stuck in a ditch, either one, like I said, we're praying for you. But I ask that you reach out to us and let us know. You can comment here, you can private message us individually or to the page, doesn't matter. And let us be praying for you specifically and individually. Because I want everyone out of the ditches and into the middle. Because it's a lot more peaceful. It's a lot less stressful. And it's a lot more freedom. And I read Galatians 4:4-7 today, or tonight at class. Jesus came to set us free. He didn't come to free us from one slavery situation so that we could pop into another one. Thanks, babe. Mm-hmm. So reach out to us. Get a hold of us. If this sounds like something that you need prayer for, we earnestly do want to pray for you about it. We do really want to be a part of your accountability team that has absolutely nothing to do with this, especially if you lost your little tag. Thanks for tuning in for the December live video. I hope to see you guys at class soon. Click on the cover on the Facebook page to blow that up. That's our full class schedule for the month of December. And let's finish out this year offering our bodies as a living sacrifice. Look forward to seeing you. Thank you for your support. Thank you for tuning in. Get a hold of us if you're interested in any of those new things coming up. And I'll hopefully see you soon.